Welcome friends, welcome to the Knowledge Club Online. Now I am going to discuss about the DNA ligase which is used for the DNA replication at the termination stage. In molecular biology, DNA ligase is a specific type of enzyme, a ligase, that facilitates the joining of DNA strands together by catalyzing the formation of a phosphodiester bond. It plays a role in repairing single-strand breaks in duplex DNA in living organisms, but some forms such as DNA ligase 4 may specifically repair double-strand breaks, that is a break in both complementary strands of DNA. Single-strand breaks are repaired by DNA ligase using the complementary strand of the double helix as a template, with the DNA ligase creating the final phosphodiester bond to fully repair the DNA. DNA ligase has application in both DNA repair and DNA replication. In addition, DNA ligase has extensive use in molecular biology laboratories for recombinant DNA experiments. Purified DNA ligase is used in gene cloning to join DNA molecules together to form recombinant DNA. What is a ligase mechanism? The mechanism of a DNA ligase is to form two covalent phosphodiester bonds between 3' hydroxyl ends of one nucleotide acceptor with the 5' phosphate and another donor. ATP is required for the ligase reaction, which process in three steps: adenylation, addition of AMP of a lysine residue in the active center of the enzyme phosphodiester is released. Transfer of the AMP to the 5' phosphate of the so-called donor, formation of a pyrophosphate bond. Formation of phosphodiester bond between the 5' phosphate of the donor and the 3' hydroxyl of the acceptor. A principal example of how a ligase works with the sticky ends, a ligase will also work with blunt ends, although higher enzyme concentrations and different reaction conditions are required. Various types of ligases are present. First, the E. coli DNA ligase. What is it? The E. coli DNA ligase is encoded by the leak gene. DNA ligase is in E. coli as well as most prokaryotes use energy gained by cleaving nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide NAD to create the phosphodiester bond. It does not ligate blunt ends of DNA expect under conditions of molecular crowding with a polyethylene glycol and cannot join RNA to DNA efficiently. Next one is T4 DNA ligase. In T4 DNA ligase, the DNA ligase from a bacteriophage, T4 is the ligase most commonly used in laboratory research. It can ligate cohesive or sticky ends of DNA oligonucleotides as well as RNA and RNA-DNA hybrids, but not single-stranded nucleic acids. It can also ligate blunt ends of DNA with much greater efficiency than E. coli DNA ligase. Unlike E. coli DNA ligase, T4 DNA ligase cannot utilize NAD, and it has an absolute requirement for ATP as a cofactor. Some engineering has been done to improve the in vitro activity of T4 DNA ligase. One successful approach, for example, tested T4 DNA ligase fused to several alternative DNA binding proteins and found that the contrast with either P50 or NF-kappa-B as fusion partners were over 160% more active in blunt end ligations for cloning purposes than wild-type T4 DNA ligase. Next one is mammalian ligases. In mammals, there are four specific types of ligases. DNA ligase 1 ligates the nascent DNA of the lagging strand after the ribonuclease H has removed the RNA primer from the Okazaki fragments. Next one is DNA ligase 3, complexes with DNA repair protection XSCC1 to aid in sealing DNA during the process of nucleotide excision repair and recombinant fragments of the all known mammalian DNA ligases. Only leak 3 has been found to be present in mitochondria. Next one is DNA ligase 4, complexes with XSCC4. It catalyzes the final step in the non-homologous end joining DNA double-strand break repair pathway. It is also required for VDJ recombination, the process that generates diversity in immunoglobulin anti-cell receptor locking during immune system development. DNA ligase from eukaryotes and some microbes uses adenosine triphosphate ATP rather than NAD. The last one is a thermostable ligase. The ligases from various thermophilic bacteria have been cloned and sequenced and are available commercially to use in ligase amplification reactions because of their thermostable properties. Now we come to the measurement of ligase activity. There are at least three different units used to measure the activity of DNA ligase. Ways unit, the amount of ligase that catalyzes the exchange of 1 nmol of 32P from inorganic pyrophosphate to ATP in 20 minutes at 37 degrees centigrade. Next one is the Modrich-Lehmann unit. This is rarely used, and one unit is defined as the amount of enzyme required to convert 100 nmols of DATN to an exonuclease 3 resistance form in 30 minutes under standard conditions. Many commercial suppliers of ligase use an arbitrary unit based on the ability of ligase to ligate cohesive ends. These units are often more subjective than quantitative and lack precision. At last, the application in molecular biology research, the DNA ligase. DNA ligase have become indispensable tools in a modern molecular biology research for generating recombinant DNA sequences. For example, DNA ligases are used with restriction enzymes to insert DNA fragments of genes into plasmid. Controlling the optimal temperature is a vital aspect of performing efficient recombination experiments involving the ligation of cohesive-ended fragments. So most experiments use T4 DNA ligase isolated from bacteriophage T4, which is most active at 37 degrees centigrade. However, for optimal ligation efficiency with the cohesive-ended fragments, sticky ends, the optimal enzyme temperature needs to be balanced with the melting temperature TM of the sticky ends being ligated. The homologous pairing of the sticky ends will not be stable because the high temperature disrupts the hydrogen bonding. A ligation reaction is most efficient when the sticky ends are already stably annealed, and a disruption of the annealing ends would therefore result in a low ligation efficiency. The shorter the overhang, the lower the TM. Since blunt-ended DNA fragments have no cohesive ends to anneal, the melting temperature is not a factor to consider within the normal temperature range of ligation reaction. However, the higher the temperature, the lower the chance that the ends to be joined will be aligned to allow for ligation molecules to move around solution more at higher temperatures. The limiting factors in blunt-end ligation is not the activity of the ligase, but rather the number of alignments between DNA fragments and that occur. The most efficient ligation temperatures for blunt-end DNA would therefore be the temperature at which the highest number of alignments can occur. The majority of blunt-end ligation can carry out at that 14 to 25 degrees centigrade overnight. The absence of stably annealed ends also means that the ligation efficiency is lower, requiring a higher ligase concentration to be used. This lecture may be helpful to you. Thank you.